stack of ice cream sandwiches and cut them right down the middle. Just like that. We're just gonna line that up. Take that prettier side, and that goes toward the outside. There we go. I think that's just enough. We're gonna take a dozen Oreos and throw them into our food processor. We're gonna add a tablespoon of milk. You just wanna mix that up so that you can make a nice Oreo crust. And I'm gonna take the crushed Oreos and we're just gonna put them into the bottom of our springform pan. And then you're gonna press it down using your spoon. All right, that ended up being the perfect amount. 12 cookies was just right. We've got about a tablespoon of milk mixed with that. Now we've got some ice cream, cookies and cream, chocolate and vanilla. You could use whatever flavor you want. Let me know which ones you would pick. We've let these melt for about 15 minutes at room temperature. And we're just gonna take about a pint is all you need. And it's gonna go straight on there. But I ended up getting the bigger ones because they were the same price. And listen, don't y'all be harassing me because I use Great Value. Some of y'all are saying, why are you shopping at Walmart? Well, if you bought as many groceries as I did, you would be shopping at Walmart too. But let me know, do y'all get the generic brand? Do you think it's just as fine? Or are you all about the fancy stuff? Are you a Trader Joe's person? What do you think? Now we're gonna take some of this magic shell. I use the chocolate fudge variety. And we're just gonna try to cover it with that shell. And you can just spread it with your spoon. Now it's time for the chocolate. We're gonna go back in with our scooper and a layer of chocolate. It's okay if it's all melty. We want it like that. There we go. And we're just gonna spread that around. I'm just using my ice cream scoop, but I bet a spatula would probably do the trick here as well. Last layer of ice cream. We're going with cookies and cream.
Oh, look at how it came right like from the store.
Did you eat some of this already?
No, they must have done it like that in the store. It wasn't me.
Kyle, you got into the ice cream, didn't you? That is a Kyle-sized bite if I've ever seen one.
Cookies and cream is my favorite.
So I'm getting three big scoops, and that should be enough for us to be able to spread this out. So we've got a layer of vanilla ice cream, a layer of chocolate, and a layer of cookies and cream. But you know, you could use strawberry, you could make this Neapolitan. There's so many different ways to customize this one. Here we go, I've got our cookies and cream spread out. Last, we're gonna add some Cool Whip. Also been allowed to thaw just a bit. I'm probably going to use half of this 8-ounce tub because I like Cool Whip. Did I use too much? I think it's going to be perfect.
It looks good to me.
And you're just going to spread that out. And then we're going to top that with whatever kind of candy or cookies you want. I'm going with cookies and cream theme with this one, but you could have chocolate chip cookies, you could have M&M's, Reese's Pieces. The options are endless. Now I decided that I'm gonna go in with more Cool Whip and we're gonna go ahead and cover the entire top. Now you can really be creative with this. You can design it however you'd like. It's completely up to you, but for me, I think it's gonna be prettier if I go ahead and just spread the Cool Whip all over so that you don't see that until you cut into it. And now to finish off, we're just gonna add some halved Oreos around the rim. And I'm just trying to be creative and come up with a design that I think will look nice, but you could do it however you like. Kyle, how am I doing?
No, do it like a clock, you know?
That's what I'm trying to do. I'm not the best with perception of death. I can tell Kyle's over here cringing. He's like, what are you doing?
I think you got it.
I'm trying.
You got one more right there.
Okay, that's not too bad.
It's not bad.
Okay, now we've got some crushed Oreos that we just chopped up, and we're just going to sprinkle those over the middle.
All right.
It's pretty.
Looks good.
I think this is working out okay.
I think that's it.
I think one more touch. We're gonna add.
Right in the middle, right?
That's not bad.
Jax is very excited about the whipped cream.
Okay, so the boys love the puppuccino, as we call this. You want a puppuccino? You want a puppuccino? Look at him, look at his. All right, stay, buddy. Stay. Stay. Go. He loves it. Looks so good. Now you're just gonna set this in the freezer for at least an hour to give our ice cream a chance to harden.
All right.
I can't wait to taste this. This was fun. Now y'all don't be afraid to try this. It looks more difficult than it is. The best tip I have for you is to make sure that you work quickly when you're dealing with those ice cream sandwiches, because once they get soft, they're really hard to manipulate. But if you get them straight out of the freezer, chop them up and put them around the rim, it's gonna be easy.
Exciting.
All right, y'all, it's been in the freezer now for a couple hours. We had plenty of time for it to set, and now I'm gonna take my springform pan and release it. I'm a little nervous. This is the moment of truth. Okay, so that's it, right? And then I just lift it?
Yep.
Okay, all right. Now, we did spray the pan with some pan spray, and then we used this parchment paper or wax paper along the outside, and here we go.
All right.
Moment of truth. Well, what do we think? It looks good! Oh my gosh! It actually looks really pretty! I was worried for a second. You doubted me too. You didn't think it was gonna turn out good, but that looks fancy.
Fancy.
But the real moment comes when we cut it in half and slice into it. We can see all the different flavors of ice cream. We use vanilla, we use chocolate, and we use cookies and cream. I almost don't wanna cut it, it's so pretty.
All right, let's do it.
I need to find the perfect place to cut it. All right, I'm gonna go in for this spot. I'm nervous. All right, and then we're gonna go right here. Okay, moment of truth.
Now, are all the layers gonna be separated? What's that gonna look like?
So nervous. Yummy! Now, one more question. Look at that, we've got our top layer is cookies and cream, and then we have chocolate, and then we have vanilla, and then we have our Oreo crust. But the question remains, are you gonna be team fork or team spoon with this one?
I already know Kyle
has to have a fork when he's having dessert, but I think if you've got ice cream, I think that constitutes as you need a spoon. Right?
Yeah, but it's kind of like a cake. So, ice cream cake. So, you got it like this.
Get some of the Oreo.
I mean, it's basically ice cream and Cool Whip and
Oreos.
I mean, what's not
the one, right? I got a bite of that that chocolate layer in the middle, mm-hmm. the shell. That
I do
added
like the shell,
to it.
Yeah. Don't forget
don't
about the shell.
Don't skip the shell. The shell was a good addition, and it's in between those layers. This is delicious.
It's all kinds of delicious, people. And it's healthy and good for you.
It is. Don't listen to him. Ice cream is not healthy. It's just yummy.
Mm-hmm. Delicious.